Hello students, welcome you back for the DBST. Today's topic for the session is on comparators. So comparators are going to compare the magnitude of two integers. So if I want to check whether the number is like ascending to descending or descending to ascending, whether the numbers are equal, we go for this verification. So that is nothing but usage of a comparator set. Comparing the magnitude of two integer numbers, the resultant output can be either greater, lesser, or equal. These are the output combinations. A is greater than B, A is equal to B, A is less than B. So first we'll find out for a 1-bit comparator, 2-bit comparator, 4-bit comparator. So 8-bit comparator is the generalized block that run. We'll have A, B inputs. The IC chip is capable of performing both are equal, therefore equal is high. 0, 1, A is less than B, is high. A 1, B 0, A is greater than B, therefore A greater than B is high. A 1, B 1, both are equal, therefore A is equal. Therefore, if you write down the equation for A is equal to B, it is a combination of A bar, B bar plus A into B. It's an XNOR operation. An X number. You write the equation for A greater than B, it is A B bar. For A less than B, it is B bar. So this is the logical case. It is X naught and it and it. Now we go for the higher question here, 4-bit comparators. So you are going to have two inputs of A naught and A one. So combination of 4 bit. Okay. So it is, you are going to compare A0, B0, A1, B1. So A1, B1 first, then A0, B1. Compare it and totally give a combination of 3 outputs, A greater than B, A less than B, and A. So the combination will be from 0, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Combinations you can make is A greater than B. So A and B take all are zero. So which will come? A equal to B. Similarly, all ones A. And when you come to, let us take this example. 0, 0, 1, 0. B 1 is 1. A 1 is 0. Clear? Okay. B 1 is 1. A 1 is. So the combination is B is greater, A is less than. So A is less than. That's why you get the output A is less than. Similarly, come for this combination. 0, 1, 0, 1. See, A naught is 1, B naught is 1. So A naught 1, B naught. Now you take the combination. A 1 is 0, B 1 is 0. Therefore, it is A1 is equal to B1, A0 is equal to B1. So, this next come to this combination. This combination. 0, 1, 0, 0. So, A1 is 0, B1 is 0, but A0 is 1, B0 is 0. A is greater than B. A is greater. This is how you make a combination. So come over here, A11, B11. So it is equal. A naught is equal to B naught. Next combination is here, A11, B11. But A naught is less than B naught. This is equal. But what happens? A naught is less than B naught. This is combination. Less equal. When you come over here, A1 is greater, A0 is also greater than A0. Therefore, A greater than B0. So this is how I make the combination of checking whether my inputs are equal, whether my inputs are lesser, my inputs are greater. The inputs are compared with A0 and B0, A1 and B0. Then you make a calculation to the effect output and write out the how many outputs you have, how many columns we have? Three columns. So this is one K-map, second K-map, this is third K-map. So we're going to find out the K-map. A greater than B, A equal to B, A less than B. It is a four variable map. Therefore, the input combination is, see here the combination B1, B0, A1, A0. So under this combination, you have written the formulas here. Substitute the values where all you get one. Substitute it and combine the see this is one odd, this is one quick, and this is one four. So there are all four ones are separate. Here one odd, holding, holding, one combination. Okay. So now you can write down the equation for A greater than B. A less than B and A greater than B. Equations are directly got from the K-map since you have the combinations of your adjoining ones. When you come for A equal to B, all the four are lying in diagram. No combination can be made. Therefore, I am using a minimization technique by Boolean loss and exclusion. So here you can find out common terms as A bar, B bar. Take the terms out. A1, A0, B0, B1. So, similarly, A1, B1, take it out and write down the equation. This is X0, this is X0. So, X0, you take it out and this is X0. Therefore, this X0, A0, B0, X0, comma, take it out. A1, B1, X0. So, A0 bar, X0, A1, X0. Now we need to draw the circuit diagram for this. So I've drawn the circuit. Four inputs A1, A0, B1, B1. And for your NOT gate, I represent A1 bar, A0 bar, B1 bar, B1. Wherever you have a dotted segment, the connections are taken. So first is A greater than B. So for A greater than B, the equation is A1, B1 bar, one AND gate. A0, B1 bar, B0 bar, second AND gate, A1, A0, B0, third AND gate, and two, one AND gate. So, three AND gates, second equation, A equal to B, one X0 gate, one X0 gate, two X0 gates, three X0 gates, two X0 gates, multiply. So, this is A. Then finally, we have A. A less than A1 bar B, then another AND gate, then another AND gate. Three AND gates and one AND gate. So this is the logical diagram for your comparator application. So depending on what many bits given, first we write on the truth table, then find out whether it is A equal to B, A less than B, A greater than 1. Fill up the columns. Find out the K-map for individual combination A greater than B, A less than B, A equal to B. After we find out the K-map, we minimize the expression by combining the ones. The second condition, ones are not being combined, therefore we minimize the expression simplification. Then finally, we draw the circuit diagram using your basic logical gates AND, NOT, OR, and X0. This is how we get the comparator circuit. This comparator circuit, we will try to use an IC chip in the lab when we do it virtually on the machine. Okay. So same thing, you apply any combination of your inputs, you can find out which one is producing an output. So once you verify in the lab, it